why street space analysis and why we are going for this approach. So in the conventional approach we are going for the transfer function approach. In this transfer function approach we are finding out any particular circuit, and from the circuit we are finding out the transfer function, and from the transfer function we are finding out the time response analysis and the frequency response analysis. We have already found out the stability of the control system with the help of this transfer function approach. Okay, but again the transfer function are having a various drawbacks also. Okay, so if I am comparing this with the conventional modern approach, these are the drawbacks as far as this transfer function analysis concerned. So first thing is that according to our definition of transfer function, it is related to the initial conditions are set to be zero. So whenever I am terming transfer function, it is the ratio of Laplace transformation of output to the Laplace transformation of input, assuming all initial conditions are set to be zero. Okay, so if the system have the initial condition which are not set to zero, we can't apply properly. So this is the limitation of the transfer function. Okay, and again the transfer function approach is applicable for the linear time invariant system only. So that is applicable for LTI systems only. So if the system is non-linear or the system is time variant, we can't apply the transfer function. Okay, it does not give any idea about the internal state of the system. We'll get the output by giving some input, but in between that, what are the system variable changes, we will not be able to find out. So the transfer function is having limitation of this thing. Fourth one is it cannot be applied to multiple input and the multiple output system. So as the classification of the control system says that we'll be having a system will be having a CISO system or the MIMO system. So for the CISO system we can apply the transfer function approach, but for the MIMO system we can't apply the transfer function approach. Another disadvantage is over here is it is comparatively difficult to perform a faster transfer function analysis on the computer. So for that the various analysis tools and the MATLAB software is available. So there is no drawback anymore, but still there is a drawback because we, in order to find out the transfer function in terms of computers, we require special tools. So in order to have a good command of analysis of control system, we'll be using a state space analysis. So what are the advantages of state space analysis? It can be applicable to non-linear systems also, and it will be applicable to the time invariant system as a time variant system also. Okay, so the previous drawback was like this, it will be applicable to only linear and time invariant systems. So over here it can be applicable for non-linear system also, and it will be applicable for both the time variant and the time invariant systems also. Okay, again it will be applicable for MIMO system, that is multiple input and multiple out systems, and it gives the idea about the internal state of the system. So whatever the disadvantages which is mentioned over here, it will be overcome by the state space analysis approach. This is the biggest advantage over here. Okay, so what is actually the state space analysis? It is the state space analysis, the excellent method for the design and analysis of the control system, which is conventional and the old method for the design and analysis of control system for the transfer function method. So over the transfer function method we are having advantages like this. So we can have accurate analysis as well as the accurate performance of the system. Now again there are another classical approach like this transfer function. So we'll be having another advantages over here also. But the important advantage of the state space over the classical approach is what? The conventional indicators of the closed loop performance are the location of the closed loop pores. As we have gone through in our concept of stability, the closed loop pores are the most important part as far as the determining the stability of the system. Okay, but for higher order system, by varying the limited number of constant or the coefficient values in the controller transfer function, one can vary the location of only a few closed loop poles but not all of them. Okay, so suppose my system is having a two poles. Okay, so if I am varying the pole, let us say the pole is located at -1, pole number 1 is located at -1, and pole number 2 is located at -2. Okay, I am varying the location of the pole, I am moving this minus one pole towards minus infinity. Let us say I am moving to minus 3 and minus 2 I am moving to minus 4. Okay, so if I am going to a classical approach, I can move this any particular pole one by one. Okay, I can move this pole one only at a time, and after some time I can move this pole, second pole also. But if I am moving this pole with the help of state space analysis, I can do simultaneously. So both the pole can be varied and we can have a accurate result as well as accurate analysis. So this is the important advantage of the state space over the classical approach. So there are various examples have been given in the different videos whose reference I have mentioned earlier also, and we are going to give the reference in the end of this slide also. So the biggest example is on off switch, that is nothing but the conventional switch which we are using at our home. Okay, so there are only two positions, either it will be on position or the off position. So these are nothing but the state of that switch. Okay, the state of the switch can assume one of the two possible states, either it will be an on state or it will be a off state. So suppose if it is an on condition, the future state will be known to us, it will be a most probably off state only. So the state space analysis concept is basically dependent on this. If we are able to know the present state, we will be able to know future state. Okay, right now it is a on state, so I can know the next state will be the off state. Okay, so it is a assuming part of any system. So this state is, right now it is the x state, in future it will be a y state. So how, this is how the state space is approached. So for that we need to have an idea about the various building blocks of the state space analysis. Okay, so these are the various definition of the states vector and the state space. Okay, so what we are doing right now is we'll be having a system in which we are giving some input and we are getting the output, but in between that we'll be having some states. Okay, so the states are giving me the information of what are the future possible systems are. Okay, so I'm taking example of any MIMO system. So there will be a number of inputs. Okay, there will be inputs, let us say these input are u1 of t up to ur of t. Okay, and the system is of nth order, it will be a first order system, second order system, or let us say n order systems also. And the output, again it is a MIMO system, so we'll be having a multiple output y1 to y1m output signal. Okay, for this system we'll be having a different state variable. Let us say these variables are x1 of t, x2 of t up to xn of t. So for the nth order system we'll be having a n state variable. Okay, so we can have another advantage is that we'll be having a nth order system can be represented by the nth state variable. Okay, in the previous analysis it was not like that. So this is again advantages over here also. So what if I am just simplifying this diagram, we'll be having a u1 u2 and ur input, and the control system will be present which will be having a state variables, that is nothing but total n number of state variables, and the output are nothing but y1 y2 up to ym, and the state variables are nothing but x1 x2 and xn. Okay, so what are these states? So let us define the state. The state of a dynamic system is the smallest set of variables called the state variable, such that the knowledge of these variables at time t is equal to 0 together with the knowledge of input for time which is lesser than 0 completely determines the behavior of the system any time which is t greater or equal to t 0. So initially we will be having a system at t is equal to 0. Okay, so suppose if I am selecting any state variable, okay, and if I am having a knowledge of input at initial condition, okay, so at initial condition I will be having a knowledge of state variables and the input. Okay, if I am knowing this at the initial stage, if it determines the behavior at time t is equal to is greater or equal to t 0, so this variables are nothing called as a state. Okay, so this is the definition of state variables. Another one definition is a state vector. If a state variables are needed to completely determine decide the behavior of a given system, then this n state variables can be considered as a n component of a vector x. Okay, so the simple definition is like that. I have selected number of state variables. So if I am making the vector of this variables, this is nothing but the state vector. Okay, state space vector definition. The n dimensional space whose coordinates axis consist of x1 axis, x2 axis, xn axis, where x1, x2 and xn are the state variables, is called a state space analysis. So in state space we are analyzing this spaces, that is state space, whatever the state variables we have chosen. Okay, so this is the basics, three definition of state, that is the state space and the state variable. State variable is nothing but the vector of the state variable. State variable or the state is the physical condition of the system. Okay, so just you need to go through this definition very carefully, because these are very important part. Okay, now we are going for the system block diagram in our lecture number 2. So right now we are closing this particular video. Next video will be uploaded by tomorrow.